بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficial and the most merciful. Praise be to Allah, the sustainer and nourisher of the whole universe. And the prayers and blessings be upon his final prophet and messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hello everybody, inside and outside our country, all over the world. You are welcome to some lectures concerning learning Islam in English for those who are interested in studying about Islam and who are not Arab and do not know the Arabic language. Here are a series of lectures concerning learning doctrine, faith or belief in Allah, which are from the book written by one famous and well-known Imam, who is Abdul Aziz ibn Baz. May Allah have mercy on him, rahimahullah ta'ala, who died 1419, who wrote the book which is called in Arabic Al-Aqidah Al-Sahihah Wama Yudadduha, translated as the correct belief and what opposes it. And there is an appendix at the end of the book concerning the nullifiers of Islam, the things that may invalidate your belief in Allah if you commit one of them. The correct belief and what opposes it is a summarized book that tell us about what's Iman and what are the pillars of Iman. Here are an introduction concerning this book. In this treatise, Imam Ibn Baz, may Allah have mercy on him, outlines the creed of Ahlus Sunnah with regard to Iman, faith, Tawheed worship, and Allah's names and attributes in a concise and informative manner. He divides his discussion into six sections, basing it on the six pillars of Iman. These six pillars are belief in Allah, His angels, His books, His messengers, the last day, and divine pre-decree. These are the six pillars of Iman on which the whole book is based. Okay, Imam Ibn Baz is going to explain and tell us some benefit information concerning these five pillars of Iman. The importance of learning Iman and faith appears in his speech in the beginning of the book, saying that it's well known from the religious texts of the Holy Quran and the Sunnah that person's statements and actions are only considered valid and acceptable by Allah if they are, you see, it's very important to know about Iman and belief and to correct your Iman and belief in Allah. That's because all your actions, statements and your deeds will not be acceptable by Allah, will not be accepted unless they are based on a correct belief. He said that if they are produced as a result of having a correct belief. So if one's belief are not correct, he invalidates whatever statement and actions branch out of it. As Allah says, وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالْإِيمَانِ فَقَدْ حَبِطَ عَمَلُهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And whoever rejects faith, Iman, then he has nullified his good deeds. And in the hereafter, he will be from among the losers. You will lose all of your good deeds and al-amal al-salih if you commit thing which is considered as shirk, or is considered as disbelief, kufr, shirk, polytheism. If you commit anything considered shirk or disbelief, you will lose all your good deeds. So you have to be careful about what is called shirk, what is called disbelief, and you have to be careful also about learning the correct belief, so as to build all your actions and attitudes and good deeds upon a very strong foundation. This also will be important if you read in the Holy Quran, chapter number 39, Surat Az-Zumar, verse number 65. Allah says, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And indeed it has been revealed to you, Muhammad, as it was to those all messengers before you, if you join others in worship with Allah, then surely all your deeds will be vain, and you will certainly be among the losers. In this ayah, you notice that the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, who is the best man Allah has created, Allah told him and revealed to him that if you commit something which is considered as shirk, although Muhammad ﷺ, the peace and blessings be upon him, and all the messengers of Allah, and all the righteous people and the good worshippers, all of them don't commit shirk. But here, if they did something which is considered as shirk or disbelief, all their good deeds that they have done will be of no value. This means that shirk invalidates every good deed that a man does. So from all of this verse and what we mentioned before, we understand that it is very important for everyone who embraces Islam who is interested in learning Islam to know that the very important thing in Islam is to know what is the correct belief and what are the things that opposes it. Inshallah, in the following lectures we will give more details concerning these issues.